Hey, what's up guys, welcome back to my YouTube video, and in today's video I'll be sharing with you how to transform your mother's skin tone from this one to this one in the Photoshop. Alright, before we jump right into the Photoshop, firstly I want to tell you this. To achieve this look, firstly you have to plan from your photo shoot. So basically you want to make sure to shoot in the daytime or in the time that you have the sun's going on the cloudy day, because if you shoot on the cloudy day, this look will look so super weird. So please make sure to shoot in the daytime and make sure on a cloudy day. So let's just get started. Okay, so the first thing, as you can see, the crop is kind of look weird over here, but just, you know, never mind about it, because it's not what are we focusing on today. We are focusing on how to make the model skin tone look really golden one. Of course, on the crop I will fix it later, so let's jump right into it. So the first thing that I do here, firstly, I use the sensitive color to make her skin tone a little bit more brighter, you know what I mean? Like, we just go on this property over here and just shift the red to the left side on a little bit and bump up the black to make it, you know, kind of more brighter over here. As you can see, I'm showing you right now, it looks a bit more brighter. And then we go on the yellow channel. I kind of darken it, because you know, if you go on the bright, it's kind of make her skin tone kind of paling. So we just kind of go to the right side over here to darken her yellow, you know, tone over there, to make it kind of more depth right over there. Alright, so we're finishing on the skin tone. Let's jump right into the background area. So on the background area over here, I just changing a little bit of the color in the background right over here and somewhere else. Let me just before and after again. Just right over here, just right on top over here, just a little bit. Okay, I will skip on this part because we're not focusing on those things. Alright, let's skip it. Alright, so it's come to this one. This one is a huge change in here, as you can see. If you go to before and after, it's kind of really proper skin tone to that golden tone look that we want. So I want to show you how I do this. It's actually very simple. Alright, so firstly you want to hold Shift Control Alt E, so you will merge all the layer down there and then create a new one on top right over here. And then you want to go to filter, camera filter, and the key thing you want to do here is you just want to raise up the temperature just a little touch, something like maybe 6. Okay, let's go, this go with 6, and lift the tint to the left side a little bit to make everything look kind of, that's kind of, you know, that's kind of golden tone, I would say. And let's redo the highlight, so get some detail on her skin, and lift up the shadow to make everything more brighter. And of course we're gonna increase the exposure to something like this one, and let's add some contrast a little bit to make it more pop. Let's redo the saturation because it's gonna look too much not natural, but we're gonna increase the vibrance. Alright, that's it, and let's see before and after. Cool, let's kick. Okay, so now you know how I make that golden tone look on this layer. So let's just, you know, stay on this layer because it's kind of more accurate. Alright, let's move on to the next thing I have done here. This one, mostly it's on the background, so I will just skip it. I will not explain anything, but I will show you what is the difference over there. Let's see, you see it's a desaturated color over here in the background. And this one, oh, I add the blur. Alright, so if you interested what I use the blur here, I just use the gradient blur over here. I just go to the blur and the radial blur, sorry, not gradient blur, let's radial blur over here, and just click right over here. And you're gonna see it's kinda, you know, when you click OK, it's gonna create some, because the opacity is kinda low. So if you see, if go up over here, let's just go, let me just go, alright, now you can see. You see, it's the blur is kinda look like kinda spinning around, you know, like the kinda spiral. I mean, I kinda like it because like when you reduce the opacity over here, it's just going to create the depth of field that is kinda drawing the attention eyes of the audience to the model. So that's why I use this radiant blur. Alright, let's move on. What are the next thing? This one I just add some kind of depth of field and clean up the background over here.
Another blur again. Alright, I blur kind of a lot in this image. And we just reduce the blue, the sign in the background right over here. When we add some blue there, okay, let me expand on this layer. The reason I add some blue in the background on this layer because I just want, you know, to make that color separation, because you see, if I make everything looks kind of warm color, it just make my model really, like, you know, blended to all the background area. But when I create some blue over here, it just going to separate her from the background. This might just kind of darken the background area. Oh, I remove this area over here. And okay guys, if you want me to show you how to remove things from the background, please make sure to comment down below and I will do on the next video. And again, I just remove things in the background. Let's kind of blur things out to make it more clean. And this one is just, I don't actually know what happened over here. Alright, oh, this one is kind of huge change over here. So if you want to, okay, let me show you how I do this one. It's kind of make her more pop. It actually, again, in the camera filter. So let me just shift control alt e over here. Alright, we're gonna go to filter and the camera filter right here. So as you can see on the previous layer, I didn't adjust anything on the color, but I kind of playing around with the lighting. So what I have done here is just increase the exposure, you know, to make it more brighter, reduce the highlights, always reduce the highlight but bump up the white, so you see it's gonna look more like natural and pop. And let's just add a bit of the contrast. Oh my god, looks so juicy to me. All right let's just click OK. See the see before and after, look pretty nice and clean. Alright, but that, let's stick on the previous layer. Let's delete it. Yeah, kind of darken the background area over here again. And clean up the background area. This area was kind of a little bit like problematic. That's why I kind of do like so many layers on this one. Now I extended the background area right here. This one and this one. Again, at the mall, and clean up all. So since I have already shown you all those steps in the background area, what I have done over there, so now, right now, it's gonna be the real time, but I will show you how to make that golden skin tone look. So let's get started. Okay, so the first thing that you want to do here, you want to go to the curve tool right here, create the curve tool. And you want to go to this RGB, but you want to go on the green one. Okay, now we are on the green one over here. So as you can see, the curved line over here, they are the point that is going to target, you know, anything on your image. For example, at this point it's a contrast point, and this shadow, highlight and white and the black here. So what you want to do in here, firstly you want to make the point on the contrast point right here and make sure the input and output in the same number, something like this. And then you just want to slightly, you know, shift on this highlight area up just a little bit, something like this. And then of course you want to inverse the layer mask because we just want to target only the model area, not everywhere. So you want to go to the brush tool over here and make sure the brush is on the white color, and then we just want to brush on her. Oops, sorry. Yep. Alright. It's looking kind of green, as that's golden look to me. It's pretty nice already. Alright, let's move on to the next step. So next step, you want to hold shift control alt E. You want to go to filter, camera filter. And remember what we have done previously, we will increase the temperature right over here, right, to something maybe around 5. We're gonna do the same, but this time we want to increase the pink color, so it's just going to balance thing out, something like this. And at this point I want to increase the vibrance kind of crazy a lot, but of course we're gonna reduce the saturation again. And now let's put on the color mixer over here. You want to increase the orange to something at this point, So the yellow in the saturation, of course. And the hue, let's move the yellow on the right a little bit to make this kind of green golden look. All right, let's just see before and after. Cool, look good to me. All right, and that's all for today, guys. And if you like this video, please make sure to subscribe and hit that like button. And please make sure to comment down below what you want to see me do next on the next video. All right, see you guys. Bye.